Hello. Thank you for joining me on the plein air tutorial. This is the second or third part. I don't know yet how I'm going to edit it all together. In the first part, or the first two videos, or one video, whatever it is, I show you how to prepare the wood to paint oil on spatula. We only use spatula. We don't use any pencil or nothing. So I'm using this wood which we prepared on the other video, and we paint now the seaside over here like that. But what we have to be careful when we go plein air, you have to be careful of the sun, how the sun is standing, because this way we only have about something like 3 hours, the sun is going to disappear behind those trees. Then the shadow is going to fall down here, down the beach side. So you have a totally different contrast, a different imagery. So that's one thing you should think about before you start painting plein air. What else you need to know is, I'll just explain you while I go along. It's my cavalletto, my easel. I don't know if you see it. Well, it's my easel there. And this mister there with the dog reading the newspaper. He took the place where I like to usually paint, because it's kind of nice, like a little table type of thing. But we do it from here. And hope you're going to enjoy this. Important thing about... Oh, yes. The universe is with me. He's leaving, so I'm going to take that spot. I'm going to take it straight away. important thing about doing your plein air is that you have the right gear, the right clothing with you. Because look, I went out with all this. If I keep all this on, you'll be sweating, and then later when the sun is... or when the wind is coming up, then you're gonna be all sweaty and starting cold, and you're gonna call yourself a meningitis or something. You have to think of that as well. You know, your clothing, have the right things with you. Well, I've got my easel, I've got a bucket with all the paper to put all the paper inside. This is my thing for putting on the head later when I show you how to paint it. I've got a bag of extra paint, but this is only for the video, because I don't want to run out of paint when I'm on the video. But I got plenty enough in this little easel in here. There's really enough paint to do like a small painting. So you don't have to worry about paint not having enough, or just taking too much with you, because the oil paint, the tubing of the oil paint is lead, and that's quite heavy. So if you have like your bag full of lead, while you sometimes walking up the hill or something, you know, like you want to have a nice painting from up the hill, you want to have light gear with you. And sorry about waffling on. I just trying to think of all the things which are important to you to get a really nice painting, especially if you only just starting. You don't want some bad things to happen straight away, because then you just get like, oh god, I don't know, I'm never gonna do this again, you know. So, you know, just choose yourself a nice day, you know, the right clothing for it, the nice day. You can go t-shirt like me now, you know, t-shirt. We have middle in the winter here now in Italy, North Italy, on the Riviera side, full of plastic everywhere. I'll clean it up eventually, I think. Okay, so, I'll show you how to set it up. And then let's go with painting. The rest I'll just explain you while I'm going along. Okay? Okay, have fun. Here I've got a small easel. You can have a slightly larger one. But I think that one is just sufficient because the bigger one is just getting bulky again. With this one you're much better off like going around narrow places in between bushes and things up there in the mountains, you know, and I prefer this one much more. And it's lighter as well. You know, the bigger one, obviously you put more paint inside, and more paint, more lead, obviously, more lead tubes, and heavier the whole thing. So this one is perfect. You don't think, you might think, oh God, it's a bit small, I can't take all my paint with me. But look, you're doing a 2-3 hours painting, and so what you need for 2-3 hours, you just need about this much oil paint is enough for you, you know. In my case, I took a little bit more, like, because just in case, if I haven't got one paint which I'm missing on the, and I'm doing the video and I've got it, you know, so I just thought, okay, just in case, take some more. But I've got everything here, really. This is how I used to paint all the time, like this, you know, and I still will, you know, that's all I need. Okay, so yeah, the handy thing about this, it's I'm using this like a surface for my palette, okay? So I'm just gonna take all this paint out, all the tubes. And my spatulas. I am one-handed now. Also, what you have to be careful when you paint on the beach, you don't want too much wind, because the wind is blowing little sand corns into your oil paint, and it's really complicated to paint it then. You can do it, I did it, but it's so annoying because you have this fine little grit in there. So when you pull your palette knife, especially over the wood, it's not so bad on linen canvas, because linen canvas, they have like a sort of, you know, they have like a, this, what do you call it? Like, it's woven, so the sand corn can hide inside one of these woven gritty things, so that's not so bad there. Still though is, but on wood, oh my God, it's just so annoying, so horrible. You have sand. I had sand in there all everywhere, you know, just like. So it was quite a windy day, but it was beautiful because the waves. It was amazing. You had just really high waves and crashing and beautiful, really nice, spectacular to paint, but the sand inside my palette was horrible. Yeah, here this is just ordinary baking powder. I hope you see all this. Let me check. Yeah, not really. Okay, so I have to look down like this when I show you that, and then I look up when I show you that. Yeah, sure. Okay. Right then. Yeah, that's just like a baking paper. I use this for, you know, to keep the paint fresh and so that it spread all over the place. Yeah, oh, what I didn't show you is this is, you know, this blue tack putty, you know, like, well, it's white here, but used to call it blue tack, as I remember when it first sort of appeared on the market quite a few years back. It's just like some putty stuff, which is a bit very sticky. You get sticky everywhere. It's just amazing stuff. It comes handy for so many things. And I just put this down here like this, just to hold my palette down, you know. like this, but and I put my palette like this, and it's there. So I've got my table, my palette table, and this baking powder. See, it keeps all the paint fresh. You just have to be careful when you have like flakes like this. This you just have to scrape off, because then you have like a bit like the problem with the sand corn, that you have this little bits inside. Hang on, before we do this, let's put our canvas, our wooden board, which I showed you on the other video. I don't know if you've seen it, but if you have not seen it, then please go on it and look how I prepare this marine ply birch wood. It's birch, light birch wood. Tell you what as well, I'm gonna put some blue tuck here as well, so that way I can keep this up there and paint up here for the beginning. Blue tuck, yes, I'm here now. Here. Like that. That's sufficient, really, you know, if you haven't got strong wind, that holds you, I think. Okay. Yeah, see the flake things? You don't want them, you just scrape them off. They keep the nice paint. It's always a shame when you have some leftover and you don't want to throw it away, so one day if you're big and famous, you sell these for 1.5 million, I think. Yeah, I think something like that, 1.5 million you can get for this piece of paper. Yeah. You just need to have your name. You can do any sorts of things. Just need your name. Just you have to be lucky that someone really appreciates your work and think, wow, I'm gonna make him big. I'm gonna buy a painting for £2 million or dollars or whatever. And then boom, and you're a rich man. And then you can only sell sorry about that. Yeah, I'm just talking rubbish. It's not about money, you know what I mean? We're doing this for fun. Yeah. Of course, you want to live with it as well. It's nice to have your hobby as a job, like making music in a rock band or whatever, you know, but that's the same again. You just need to have someone who's like really into your work and you're rocking. But now we stay with the fun. We enjoy this beautiful day, this beautiful view, and we make a nice painting. Yeah, the bucket is just for my paper, to put all the paper in and to keep this out of the sand. That's all really why I got a bucket. It's a handy thing as well. So you got your easel, your bucket, maybe a rucksack, you know, to put your things in, and what is it? Da-da-da-da. Let's clean first. Let's clean it first. Yeah, these flakes, you don't want them. This is all nice here. The blue. Let's get rid of all of this. There's some flake things in there. Let's get rid of it. We can keep this part there. You know, sometimes it's nice to keep this as well separately, because you can sort of put it in, you know, like in your painting, on rocks, on things, on bushes. It's nice because you have patterns, you know, and makes it really easy, fast and very effective. There, this spatula is not really for this kind of thing. But I'll show you which spatula I use for this cleaning thing. You can use one of these. I got it. That's a brush just to brush dust off somewhere. Oh, I didn't bring it. It doesn't matter, I've got another one. And it's here. That one is a really good spatula for big surfaces, you know. But also for cleaning. Yeah, because when you get these flaky things in your paint, you cannot spread. But you know what I mean, if you, like say you have some fresh paint on there and you just take some of this and then just dab it on there, you know, and then you have very effective, I'll show you that on a different video. Well, there actually is someone, a French guy, I forgot his name now, older guy, he's amazing. It's shame on me that I can't remember his name. But if I think long enough, I'll probably get his name. But I can always add this on below the video as well. His technique is amazing. He just scrapes off things like that, you know, like that. And then for me, he's a great master of spatula painting. Love his style. Mind you, don't know if I like so much the pictures. They're a bit, I don't know, but, well, it's amazing. Really, really good technique. But, there's something about the colors which I don't know. Sorry to say that, I have to cut this out because it's not really true. I love this stuff and that's it. I love it. But yeah, it's a positive criticism, you know. Every artist has to take that, you know. You have to listen also to other people, even if it's just, if you know you're good, you know you are good, that's good to know. You know, but open your ears to other people as well, you know. They might have their opinion and you say, well, yeah, he's right. But I know I'm better than that. Well, which you are, you're better than that. You just, because you are always working on it and getting better, yeah. It's the motifs which I don't like so much about his stuff, you know. It's like the seascape's beautiful, yeah, very nice, but then he has like some things with the torero, you know, and it's not my thing. It's just not my but you get always some lover for something, you know, like there's some people who love that type of stuff. The seaside's so really good. Okay, I think I scrapped enough. Just make sure you don't have these things. Oh, no, this goes in the white paint now. That's enough. That's clean. I've not even started the painting and I'm already messy. Okay. Make sure that your palette knives are always clean, shiny clean. They have to always be shiny clean. Also when you're painting, you know, I'm just making a quick wipe like this, but it has to be wiped properly, you know, because you put it on there and then there's some paint left on the other, and then, oh no. I'm sorry. Okay, now we start putting. One thing I want to show you is a thing I've got. John Silver, he's a cartoon artist, or well, he's a character designer, I think. Yeah, character designer. He teaches. He does some seminars all around the world. He's amazing, really. He's teaching you really simple way of drawing faster people, characters, and that is. He makes it so easy. Well, and he makes these things here. See, silver. I don't know if you can see it. Silver, on silver. And he makes these dividers, which always shows you the rule of third. You know the rule of third, no? It's where it's for composing your painting to have how do you explain it? You just look it up on Google it. It's important, really, the rule of third in your paintings, or in any artwork, photography, everywhere, design of object materials which you use, like a fridge. That's what John Silver made a good point on that. Have a look on all the designs which are made. They are all made with the rule of third. Look at this, the fridge. He has it's always 3/4 of the thing. And what I'm looking for is some masking tape. I've got some pink masking tape. I hope I did bring it. If not, it's not so bad. Not too bad. That's strange. Sure, I had it with me. There it is. Okay. And a pencil. Which we have. Wow. Yeah, for the horizon, it's nice to have have the rule of third in here as well. So you measure this like this, and here goes the horizon. Same on the other side. Yeah, that's it. Rule of third, amazing little tool. Thank you, John Silver. This is masking tape, which is not too mega sticky, you know, so. So you get it off easy. Now the paints. As I said, I've got all the paints with me in here. Just to make this video faster as well, I'm going to use the big ones first. Well, let's see what we got here. Right, so we want for the sea, we want ultramarine and some primary blue. primary blue. Blue primario. Primary blue. Primary blue and some ultramarine. I'm gonna. Yeah, usually. Yeah, I might order like this. I prefer it like that. Ultramarine. We don't need that much. We don't need that much. And some primary blue. Ultramarine, you see, has like slightly reddish, it's slightly purpley. And the purple we need as well, we need some magenta. This is magenta. Primary magenta. For in the sky, look over there, you see in the horizon, the very back, the blurry thing, you know, that's all sort of purpley. You put some magenta in there. So we got magenta, we got the blue, baby. So now we want the green for the hills up there, which is it's a beautiful green around here. It's like all the olive trees and pine trees and the earth coming through. So we need, we have a really nice one which I found here in Italy, Terra Verde. I don't know, it's green earth, okay? I don't know if you know this one, if you find it around your place, but look at it already. Well, this is about the tone, just need it a bit darker. You can, maybe Hooker's Green is good for this as well. Hooker's Green. But we mix this as well. We mix this. We put some Pain Gray goes really well with green. It makes, because Pain Gray, if you put some white in Pain Gray. Pain's Gray, where is it? Cinabro Green Deep, what's this? Oh, I'll put this in there as well. Always play around, you know, always play with your colors. Don't be always like, oh, yeah, I need to have this color and all that. Play around, you know, it's about the tones, not really about the color. Well, also the color, the mix of everything. But be free, be free with all your paintings, you know, just. Paint's Gray, I've got some Paint's Gray here, so, but. Look in here. Don't tell me I didn't bring Paint Gray, but Paint Gray. Look at it, it says like bluish. It's like a blue greenish. We put that here next to the Van Dyke brown. Look, it's almost blue. Put a bit much in there. Okay, Paint Gray. Then Van Dyke brown. We have a little one in there, but I'm going to use the big ones first. Okay. What's that? Burnt sienna, no? Let me do that as well. Van Dyke brown. Yeah. Didn't bring in the big one. Okay, we'll have small ones. Van Dyke. Right. Van Dyke. Ooh. And there's another one, but I was going to say, because you need quite a lot of Van Dyke. But always put bit by bit, always. You can always put some afterwards. But yeah, Van Dyke and white, you need more. So we have that, the Van Dyke, we've got Paint's Gray. Now we have some, we've gone out for the earthy color, which is like a rose sienna. Then some burnt sienna. Burnt sienna, we've seen down here. Burnt sienna. There we some giallo di Napoli, Naples yellow. Yeah, Naples yellow. So we do have the green, green, green. Put some of this here, it'll be dumb. It's probably not gonna find this, but never know, you mix it in somehow. Okay, we got the blues, we got the burnt sienna, ocra gialla. Why not? It's nice to have a little bit of variety for, because you have some of the earth. Then you have the buildings, you know, all the colors, the different colors of the buildings over there. There's some rosa, rosé, some yellowish, some white, some greenish yellow. Yeah, so might as well have like a bit of a variety there for all that. For your earth and for your buildings. Okay, now... now we have all these colors, yellow, 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 yellow. We need the white. And what I do with the white, I put a dab of white on each corner. That way I can lighten up different colors without without mixing them up too much. That's it. We can start rock and roll. It's by time because the sun is already over there. So we have about 2 hours, and then we start. Then we start having a shadow coming up here. So better hurry up, unless I want the shadow in there as well. Let's see. Start mixing with the sky first. Hazy, yellow. Take your time with mixing. You know, that's the fun of painting, especially with spatula, because with a spatula you don't need diluenti, no dilutives, I think. And you know, you'd always have this nice pasty thing. Also, eventually, not here right now for the graded sky. It's very graded over there, you see. So I'm mixing quite well, but if you do like so landscape and things like that, try not to mix it too much, because then it's nice to have this different color nuance, this color grading. Okay, so we need a bit of magenta in here, just a little bit, because it is already sort of purpley. Yeah, purpley. Then we have some, let's put this over there, like that. Then we have some the haze, it's a little bit of Naples yellow is also in there. Naples yellow, I think that's already a nice color here. Maybe a bit too dark, but we can always lighten it up down there. So, well, we have the island here, but I'm gonna just go all over it, you know, so because then I don't have to fix all around it. And because you when you start doing like the island first and then you have to go around and then again, it just, you lose a lot of time, you know. So let's just do the whole thing. And straight away up there you can put it with your fingers. Some pretty girl on YouTube, pretty girl, well, she's a lady, young lady, Australian, I don't know, forgot her name as well. She shows it really nice, like, put your finger on there, and that's true, she's right, just, you know, don't be scared, just using your finger inside. I'll probably mention her on the bottom of the video as well, she's really sweet, I like her, gorgeous girl as well. Really, really nice girl. Nice attitude, pretty. Yeah, I like her. Okay. I'll find out her name. I'm going to write it down. Yeah, you ought to watch her videos as well. She's really good. Really good. So we're going slightly lighter now, on like so more magenta, okay? So lighter, the same color we just mixed, a bit lighter, but we put also a little bit more magenta in there. Simple. What you see is what you mix. You know, you see, you look over there, you see, oh yeah, it's going so purpley down there. And don't forget, you have a slightly darker down here with the mountains. I don't know if you see on this video, on the camera, with my eyes from here, I can see it well, but I don't know if you can see it. Okay. So lighter, we said, and a bit more magenta. Let's put some more. Don't be scared. Go for it. You can always change it, you know. If you don't like it, change it. A bit more giallo Napoli, Naples yellow. Ooh, I just took the whole white. Oh, why not? Okay, let's have a look. No, it's not. Oh, I want some more magenta. I want some more magenta in here. Ooh, it's maybe too much. That's good. Yeah, this is what I want. And then we mix it over. Well, here we have the rot, but bring it over, because otherwise you just have a lot of hassle getting the lines right. You can just scrape it out again after with the mountains coming up like that, I think. Da-da-da-da. You can sometimes put like little circles in, you know, like so, like to mix them and to have like sort of, you know, the cloudy misty thing. Sometimes go back as well, because sometimes when you do rough, it can happen that it's already perfect rough, you know. But we refine it a little bit more. Let your spatula do it. You just look. You just watch it all happening. Just allow it. See, this is these little things, what I'm saying. This little dried oil paint. That's why clean your palette nice. Your palette. And your palette knife. Clean everything really nicely. So this is the stratus. And it's coming like, you see, it's coming up like that. So we might as well bring that. The clouds up there, you know, like, gives a bit more dimension. But you see, it works really fine, this wood, with marble dust, or baby bottom powder, talcum powder, that's it, talcum powder. Oh, it works fine. As long as it's not sand, ooh. I made another video with sand, and I thought, yeah, I might as well show you as well how it can be when you're having problems like that. But in the end, it got so annoying, and then I thought, oh, bro, scrap this, and I just left it. Yeah, give it a bit more. You know, but it's a nice purpley sky. Yeah, it's like a purpley yellow. We have Naples yellow in there. And some magenta. And for the cloud up there. I might put in later as well, like to just like, you know, yeah. We just refine here a little bit more. We need this. Try. As I say, let the spatula do the work. You just watch. Yeah, I don't like these bits. You can really do loads of, you know, do it nice and properly, you know. But this is because I'm showing you this video, the whole thing. I only have not even 2 hours left. I have to get on with it, you know. But otherwise, you can fix more, you can shade it more, you know, you get a really nice thing, you know. But sometimes it's quite nice, a bit of roughness in here, because sometimes you have like a bit of disguise, like, you know, I like this up here. Okay, here where the mountain is, you don't want to have it too different than the others. That'll do for now. We can always put some clouds in afterwards. Okay, so we have that. Now we clean down here a little bit because we don't want so much paint on here. Because then we have the cappella, the little chapel there. And we have this. Here I have to bring it down more. Here I have to bring it down. Yeah, if you see me doing this and you see, I know a better way of something like that, you know, about something technical wise, then please mention it on the comment. Really, it's very much appreciated, because, you know, we share our knowledge. That's why we have the internet. We have all the knowledge of the world. Everyone. And we can share it all together. We share it all together. That's right, here, just in case there's no mountain there. Okay, so we got it almost all covered now. Sky's done for now. Now we have the horizon, which is again purple, more darker purple. So we use even more magenta now, and a bit more blue. This one, and a bit more magenta. Oh, see? And we have some brown. Sometimes accidents like that happen, and it's not bad as well, because sometimes it's just the right thing. I think it's a bit too dark. Let's lighten it up a little bit more. Because once you put it on the canvas, I see they have the brown in there now. Why not? Leave it in there. Accidents happen and can be just the right thing. We have it a bit more magenta. More magenta even. Let's go for it. Come on, magenta. There's all blue. Just to clean my nose. I was painting here the other day, and that's why I warned you this early on the start of the video. Make sure you dress right, because I was here painting all dressed up, and then excuse me, and then you had. And I was sweating, and then suddenly came the cold breeze, and the sun was disappearing over there. They had the shade here, and it started getting really cold, but I had to finish the painting, and that's how I got a bit of a cold now. But I don't want you to listen to my sniffling all the time, so I better clean it now. So we have the mountain coming down like this, then it's making like a curve like that. Then there's a steps. And then the capoletta here. I'll make it bigger, I'll bring it. I'll have that bigger, then I'll have further up. Further up. See that there? That's it. Another step, then we have these little steps here. So that. And then the capoletta here, okay? So let's clean this first while we add it. So this is a negative of the mountain. Clean it a little bit. Don't be afraid of your paintings. Okay, so down here, we say this is the last bit, and then we have that. Okay, so we put now the line of the Tuscany. That's Tuscany over there. That's the mountains. All the mountains you see behind the Isola Gallinara, that's all Tuscany, because Genoa is over there, so that's Italy gone now there, and then South Italy down there. Okay, so we start painting Tuscany now. The mountains of Tuscany. Let's see if it's too dark. I'll do me fine. I'll do. what we say, those steps. Yeah, la la, da da. Come on, let's see how that goes. On the mountain peaks I do later, so then we have the Isola Gallinara here. So it's that cappella. The cappella is about 'd like to get these some clouds over there as well. And I'll bring them in as well. So like there's clouds in there. Letta here. And then here we have the Isola Gallinara, so the distance is about right, no? See the measurement, so here's the Cappelletta, and here we start the Gallinara. Gallinara, the island. It's funny, it used to be a cloister, you know, like nuns used to live on there. See, the house is a convent. You know, for nuns, nuns. And eventually some rich people in Alassio bought the houses, made into the nice herrschaftliche Häuser, a nice my English sometimes, sorry, I'm not. Sometimes I take time looking for a word in English. Herrschaftlich. Well, rich people, you know, like... No, magnificent buildings. Some, yeah, they were building these... No, they were making... yes, I think they were building some as well. But the thing is, they bought it all and lots of money, and then... Porcarol, that's an island over there, behind that cape, and then you go in, well, sailing, I've been sailing there for about 2 more days in Porcarol. And the seat of the Mediterranean National Park is there, and they made a law. No more anchoring on these islands because you destroy the surface of the natural surface of the underwater plants and animals, which is correct, I think, because you just have all these yachts going out and just, you know, dragging the anchors there. I think that's okay, you know, why not? That's, you know, let the species have their house as well, you know. And well, anyway, and because of that law, it's now protected by, the whole island is now protected by this national park, and they're not allowed to live there anymore. Can you imagine how gutted they are? You know, spend lots of money to redo all the houses, these old houses of the convent. And now they're not even allowed to go on their own property anymore. Well, they probably can go on there, but they're not allowed to live there. You know, there's no pipeline. I think the water pipeline or something. But yeah, they cannot do it. They're not allowed. Okay, we don't want to do too much here. I'm taking too long, sorry. A bit of here, we have some of these clouds in there. Let's put them in. Why not? There's some clouds in there. Yeah, but we don't, you know, we don't have to. This is an oil paint. It's an spatula oil paint, and it's quite expressionistic. You don't have to do so much detail, you know. Sometimes I just get carried away, you know. Just want to have everything so perfect. And how, you know, just sometimes, you know, let's go for it. Okay, so we need this Gallinara brown. This is much too yellow, so we need some Van Dyke brown in here. Look, let's mix some in here. Let's bring some of these two over there and mix them in here. That's already much better. So we have that and that. Maybe a little bit of that, but not much. That's already a nice, the dark version of this. That's very nice. This is it. So we have Naples yellow, Sienna, natural Sienna, and burned. And Van Dyke brown. Boom. There you go. That's our earth color. And we can always lighten it up. Over there, there's a bit more yellow. See, that's why I like to have different whites. I put a bit much. Oh well. So we do a bit more, because we have the beach as well later, you know. That's all the same color, you know. There's the sand. Right, let's do some more. Okay, so bang. Bang and bang. This may be too much, a little bit. And Van Dyke. Bruno Van Dyke. That's a nice earthy the shade of the earth. And a bit more. Sometimes it's nice to keep one separate totally, because then you have like for the buildings or something, you know. Yeah, see, we had it perfect. Now, sometimes leave it, you know, just don't overdo it. Okay, so a bit more white. Already, that's the very white. Okay, we don't want to go whiter than that. That's almost white. Keep that there. So okay, we have this for the Gallinara. So we have the Gallinara. Dun, da, dun, da, 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 da. Here we go. Oh, much too dark. But why not? We get a dark first, the shade. That's like a pier down there, look. And then we have the base of. And here we have like much whiter. I better shut up now. And here you see that, this pain grey. Pain grey is one light brown and this green. It gives you a really nice shadow of the green, shadow colour of this green. Still a bit more Van Dyck, or not, sorry, a bit more of the Payne's grey and Van Dyck. This is the dark, dark, almost mega dark, and you can always light in here. Much too light now. I'm mixing a bit more because I don't want to run out of it and then I have to mix it all again, you know. Because it's the mixing part which takes the time more than anything. And then of course the little details, but the mixing part takes most of the time. Let's just do it. And I think I might have to do it with a small spatula. I'm doing the shade first, and can always put then the, yeah, I'm using the small one. I wish I had one like this, see, I'll clean it. Like this, but smaller, you know, this is a bit, even smaller. They are around, but they're really hard to find. Because when they're out in the shop, in the artist shop, they just buy it straight away. So we have you. Okay, so we don't go from there. Oh, okay. So we have it bigger. Okay. But we need like a tortoise. Like a turtle. Like a, coming over the way. No, that one again. This one, I need a smaller one. Oh, we have a turtle here. Yeah, for a little turtle. Turtle's back, coming all the way down, really. Right to the port. The port you don't hardly see. What is there? Well, we have that, and then we have like up there, and then it comes down again. slightly light over there. We have at least that lighter one here, down here in the bottom. That's where the light of the sun is coming in. Even lighter. Like that, like rocks coming, chung chung. You know, you leave it rough. Okay, not too rough, but a bit rough. That yellow I shouldn't have put in there. It's all a game of colors and tones and dark over here, right in the bottom there. And that's that grey again. I'm quite happy with it so far. We can then later put some darker ones in here. Actually, you do that already. But no, I want to do this equal, because I'm here for it, all right. We do this now. So we have Tuscany over there. We have that little port. It's much too high now, this port. No, it's okay. The paper's coming off. We have that port, and then oops, there we are. This is where the Capoletta is going to be. And there's all the hotel, front line, the buildings. Now the Capoletta. Just this rock going down like that. And then, we have like, on the heights like this. I think it's bigger. The whole thing is bigger because look over, it's going about like here. That's about right, a bit bigger. A little bit bigger. And then we have the first step here. And then we have a nice lighter color here, just a bit more white. The sun makes it a bit more yellow here, is a reflection of the sun. So look. Which we have over here as well. The roof. On the roof there's a bit as well. And on the light side of the cappelletta here. Yeah, like that. We have a rock here as well. Here we have like us also like this. Then we have undyed brown for the window. Just a tip, you know, just a tip on your thing. If you do too much, no matter, you just shift it up with the bottom part, you know, the light part which we have here. See, there, there's some little bit of light, the light part over here. And then another. And some rocks. That'll do. That's a cappelletta. And we have some rocks here as well. Shiny. Shiny ones. Not everywhere. But here and there, you know? Like that. Okay. Now the house building. Building. We have a white building over here. Right on the very top. There we go. Then we have a nice pink. Oh, we didn't put the red one yet. Red. Cadmium red. Cadmium red. We need that for the rose. La couleur rose. Rosa in English, no? Rosa? Pink. Pink. Well, pink, for me, is pink is magenta pink, but yeah, but I think in English, rosa is pink. Too big. Okay. A very good idea here, Mr. Building, to keep it too. Hotel and there's trees. Yeah, plenty of trees there. Let's do those trees. That's just about the hotel. And some really nice trees. Ooh, better hurry. But the sun is really nice and hot. I mean, if you think about it, we have middle in the winter, we have February, North Italy. I swear, this is so amazing here. I sailed down from Germany all the way. Took me 6 years on my sailing boat. And I lived on it for 6 years as well, and I was still working on animation, which I stopped doing because I just preferred going back on my oil paintings. I did tattooing for a while as well in Bristol, but I prefer doing my oil paintings, and that is what I was missing on living on the boat, because I was okay doing my tattoo work, tattoo as well, but I was okay doing my animation work on the boat. But sorry, sometimes I just like just to be quiet when I'm painting. Normally I do, but I like to explain new things as well, and sometimes I just talk things like that. Oh my god, this dog had a shit somewhere. There's a dog just had... Oh, Jesus, where did he shit? Boy, it stinks, man. So we have the steps. It's nice to have steps, you know, they don't have it all flat. June, come on, don't be scared. June, come on, Fipsy. Yeah, wait. Tip of the thing. Duck. Oh, that's a hotel building there before that. Anyway, so we just get on with it. So we have this step up here. That's why I like one of these, slightly bigger and rounder, you know. I'll get one. You probably have one. You can send it to me here, give me my address. Ah, that's better, see? Because it take more on the... This little one is for very small detail. Which this probably is, it is small detail, but... So, do we have the steps? We have that. We have the hotel. Okay, step. Step two. Up. Hotel. Next step up. June. Don't mix too much of the sky in there. Next step. June. There's some earth in there as well. Very dark. Okay, and the green, that's that step, and this step. Let's just slide. What was it? Step by step. step is, there it is. And they have those trees just here on that step. That. And we have that one going over there like that. And this is like a nice round thing. And we have yet now, we have like a green, and this one we don't mix, we just, you know, just like that. They take some of the green, take some of the brown, you know, just together like that, and then dark. You try not to mix it too much. Some green, some brown, and well, there's like terraces, there's loads of terraces. This is actually going like that. The rest of the mountain we don't see. Some of the green, some of the brown. Unfortunately, I have to mix here because we have some of the blue underneath. We don't want that. But again, we go over it again with the rough bits. But yeah, this is more or less what we want. Oh yeah, and we have some nice, lovely pine trees up there. Look at those. Yeah, here, like, just like that. One, and two big. Come. That's just getting in a hang of putting the right amount on your spatula. This is probably too much. Then we have. You know what I mean? Okay, so we have that. And we have like, so we have to come down a bit like with some of the green and the thing again. Ciao!
Bello!
Bello, oggi!
Anche ieri, che bello!
Anche tu dipingi?
No?
No?
Però mi piace le persone.
Ah?
Perché si vede, ma c'è il cuore. Non è facile, stai facendo lì.
È tutto con la spatola. Sto facendo un video tutorial per YouTube. Per... Come? Adesso faccio un po' qua e poi il mare, ti tolgo questo, poi il mare, e la spiaggia è finito.
Mm?
Sì, li vendo qui a, sai, a Piazza Torino, conosci? Ah sì?
Sì, lo incontravo sempre
quest'estate. Quest'estate?
Sì.
Ah, c'ero io?
No, un'altra persona.
Ah sì? E dove era questa altra persona?
L'ho conosciuto un giorno, me l'ha regalato una.
Ah, ma qui, sulla spiaggia?
Veniva sempre nel budella, poi si sedeva qua vicino al ristorante lì.
Ah sì?
E si metteva anche lui con le...
Col cavalletto?
Col cavalletto, col quadretto.
Ah, bello! Ah, non posso pensare chi è adesso, perché io ero qua tutta l'estate. Ah, giovane! Era, lavorava lì dove c'è quella ragazza che fa i capelli, fa anche i tatuaggi a Enè. Sì, 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 io ho messo anche i socchi.
Però adesso non l'ho più visto, devo andare per quest'estate. Ha detto che li vendeva in giro, che li comprava. Queste qua si devono più vedere.
Sì, sì. Ok, adesso le case. Sì. Adesso le case, c'è un hotel là, non so cos'è, quello bianco vicino alla cappelletta. È un hotel, vero? Facciamo un po' di bianco con un po' di blu.
Hotel Mediterraneo.
Ah, hotel Mediterraneo, ok. Molto brutto, vero? Cioè di qua, era... Lo posso vedere, ci pensi qua quando era anni, anni, anni fa, quando non c'erano tutti questi hotel, deve essere bellissimo qua. Poi lo sai che la spiaggia diventa sempre più piccola, perché il polare nord si sta scogliendo, là il mare sale. Grazie, bella giornata a te. Now I want to get some nice white with a slightly tone of, not the yellow white, because we need that as well. But to have a contrast between the yellow white and this kind of white. We make a new white here. I think this will do for our hotel over there. We have a hotel. And the base part of it is this. Okay. So we have the base part of this hotel, which is over there like that. Horrible thing. Then the right, and then we have like a mix some of these. Dirty a little bit, hopefully some shady part here of this hotel. Unless we don't get the green in there, I hope. Well, okay, it's rough, okay? You can make it more detailed if you, but you have to feel around, and of course the more you do the details, the more nicer it's gonna get as well, you know? But we do a fast one this time. It's 3 hours, maybe, 3 hours. Sometimes it works faster, you know, it just depends as well on what you do, what the motives are. Those are 3 hotels down here. You want to have maybe something, well, in my case, because I'm selling it to the tourists which come here, so then it has to sort of fit what you're having there, more or less, you know. So people can see it. They say, oh yeah, it's a Lazio, I can see it. Okay, so what we're doing? And then we have this grey again, this one. For the rocks. Yeah. Right then. Next buildings. Oh yeah, we have. See, there's like a. That's a very landmark of Alassio. I don't know if you see it. It's the road with the arches, and that's sort of a reddish. Let's do a red. That's a very red. Maybe a bit of brown sienna and red. That's a nice red. Brown sienna and red. Burnt sienna. Burnt sienna, red, and a bit of white. Oh, very rosa. Right, that's the one. Maybe a bit of this as well. Oh yeah, that's exactly what I want. It's this sort of a brick, you know, like a brick red. Okay, that's what I want. So to do this, it'd be nice if that would be clean. Okay. Let's do it. You keep it in an angle. You see, keep it in an angle and drag it down slowly. Like that. Do it again. Keep an angle. But see, you take this side of it like this. And you don't want these bits in there, but yeah. See? The side, and you take it in an angle like that. And you drag it down. Right, so those are the arches. Now we have to put the arches in. Already it's giving you some sort of contrast here. And there you need, again, you know what I say, it's a spatula between, oh, this is not clean, between that one, between this one and this one, you know, in between, that is the perfect one. So the one between, which I haven't got here, unless, no, I didn't. I didn't bring it. So you know which spatulas you need. Small, very, very detailed one is this one. And this one, and that one for your big stuff. This one is quite handy for, you know, when you build curvy things, it's quite nice for that. And hey. Okay. Let's see. Let's see if this is the one. I think this is the one. Okay. So we have a paint's grey again, paint's grey. Look at it, it's almost blue if you look at it like that. Paint's grey, it's a bluer. You would say, did they really put the right colour in there? So that's why I'm mixing it with the Van Dyke brown, which my Van Dyke brown is my black, so to say. But obviously if it's a paint grey, you get even more black, and it's like a colder black. This is a warm black. Van Dyke brown is a warm black, and mixed with Payne's grey, it makes you a cold black, which is okay for shade or shadow, under the rocks, cold rocks. Right? Okay. So we have an arch here. I hope it's not too dark. Oh yeah, it's a bit too dark. All right. Oh, okay. No, it's okay, because by dragging it now, you know, we don't want that one too dirty. Oh, that's the masking tape. We'll do that again. Hope I'm going to get the same one again. About three times. So. Doesn't matter if it's not, you know, you can always fix it. One, two, three. And then we have a tree. And then we have a house, a white one. Again. Just very angle I like. So on up there we have a bit of white again, like a creamy for the road. There's a road, obviously there's a wall up there on the road. We have to show there's a road going up there, but we don't want to. Oh yeah, look, it goes much bigger. We have the arches, only there's the trees in front. So we put some more. It's a landmark of Alassio. There we can see it is Alassio. It is very strong. So we make it a bit more nicer. So add a bit more. Buildings. Oh God, you can get carried away with the buildings and all and everything. You know, but you know, up here some buildings up there. You know, there's some white ones. This big one over there and that one over here. Big one. I don't like this one, the hotel. I like the hotel. Always, every time I do this hotel, I don't like it. But you have to have it there because it's a landmark, you know. It's a landmark. Maybe if I get this straighter, better. And then put some lines in for the balconies. They have like rows of balcony of an on the hotel. Well, let's see if I can get one. It's gonna be all like that. 1, 2, 3. Well, not too happy with that either. Sometimes you just have, you know, you're happy, you can get it. You make yourself crazy, you'll be there for ages and the day goes past and your painting doesn't look any better. This will do. You have to stop eventually somewhere. Okay, we have another white one here. Well, this is this type of white. And we have it up here. Just here, that dark. Ah. Yeah. Lost my nice. Okay, so we make this darker as well. Yeah, sometimes you just have to leave it as it is. There's some trees in front anyway. We're gonna put some trees in front. Sì, chiaro, chiaro. And there's some trees by the hotel here as well. Like that. And then we got this yellow. It's a bit of that. And we put some more houses over there, so this is this house, and this is this house. It's a bit more.
Una bella prospettiva.
grazie.
Mica roba da poco.
Mica roba da poco. No, da poco, c'è tanti palazzi che mi fa impazzire.
No, guardi, è fantastico.
Grazie.
Un po' di
rosa.
La gallinella, perfetto.
Sì, è là. Sì, con la spatula è un po' un casino, i dettagli.
No, non si butti giù perché.
Ok. Allora qua ci sono, qua poi ci sono tante piccole case qui, palazzi.
Uno, ancora.
Due.
A me tutta sta pittura moderna che vedo. A venire
in mal di stomaco. Sì, tutto.
Ormai siamo diventati tutti americani.
Sì. E la moda.
Bocchi, vaca boia, che non sai nemmeno praticamente, nonostante dico cacchio, oramai è da decine e decine di centinaia di migliaia di anni, praticamente, se non ci fosse stata la pittura,
sì.
Tutta quella che ti ha riportato la vita, la fotografia e tutto quello che era. C'era tutti questi fornuti, questi sgorbi e compagnie, siamo già ignoranti.
Sì.
Senza niente dietro praticamente non c'era proprio nulla.
Ha ragione, eh? Bello che sentire una persona che pensa così, perché anch'io penso così, eh. A me piacciono vecchi maestri, là sì che era l'arte, adesso buttano qualche colore e lo vendono merda, un pezzo di merda per un milione di euro,
sì.
Ma sono pazzi. E Dio lo chiamano arte, nell'ome dell'arte.
Sì, vabbè. Tanto se la mangeranno tutta l'arte, compresi gli iPhone. Quindi è tutto finito.
Perciò tutto bisogna riprendere di nuovo i vecchi stili.
A trovare le nuove generazioni che abbiano. Le dicono che lei è matto.
Ah sì, quello lì è matto, guarda quel pazzo là.
Le dicono che lei è matto.
Sì, è vero.
Non ci scambio nemmeno parole con tutti, perché no, per la carità c'è dei bravi ragazzi, ragazze ancora.
Sì.
Nel mucchio, insomma.
Sì.
Però la maggioranza sono tutti i poveretti.
Sì.
Sono rimasti dei poveretti, peccato che siamo in un. Oramai siamo al declino. Non so chi rimarrà, quei pochi che rimarranno. Boh. Perché è così che da finire, non sempre a fare.
Sì.
Io la penso così, poi.
Ma sì,
ma sei pessimista.
Prima o poi, sì. Perciò bisogna fare il meglio possibile che. Prima la fine.
Dobbiamo solo essere noi stessi per
sì, bravo.
E basta. Il resto.
Bravo.
Ti rispetto.
Sì.
Che non ti rispetta, fai finta di niente, perché tanto alla fine è inutile pure incazzarsi, quindi.
Chiaro, perché tanto non puoi fare niente.
No,
lottare contro l'ego degli altri.
No, è contro la natura.
Sì.
È contro la natura.
È vero. Ecco, ci abbiamo questi palazzi. Adesso non è di vista.
Va bene, la lascio lavorare, quindi.
È stato un piacere.
No, è piacere mio perché. Ero un buon pennello quando ero giovane, ed ero una buona matita.
Ah sì?
Sì.
Ah.
Sì, ma quando ero giovane.
Ok, e adesso.
È stata una delle cose praticamente
Ma faccia di nuovo, fa ancora. Ci vuole, ci vuole qui da Lazio.
Sono arrivato al punto di dire, io sono venuto a passare qua adesso 3 mesi, un altro anno, spero 4, io vengo
sì.
a passare Monferrato, Vercelli. Ed è, oramai diciamo tutto quello che potevo fare nel mio piccolo l'ho fatto.
Sì.
Quindi, e venendo qua a passare l'inverno, che è il primo inverno, ho scoperto proprio che guarda sti cazzoni porca puttana hanno il culo anche praticamente che la natura li ha baciati, se ne sbattono i coglioni.
Sì.
Ormai conosco un po' di storia, chiudono ottobre,
sì, tutto per profitto, basta che
sì,
profitto.
Sì, sì, comunque.
L'importante è il profitto.
Tanto sono alla fine, quindi qua lascio in generale tutto in vendita. Perché lei vede solo l'agenzia che vendono.
Ma l'isola Galinara privata adesso non possono neanche andare più perché se l'ha preso Porcarol, la isola, lo sa di Porcarol che Nature Park, parco nazionale che non possono più abitarci.
Bene,
bello, no? Io sono contento perché prima era un convento, poi qualche ricchi si sono comprati. Sì, però bello che è bello.
Poi
bello, anch'io sono contento di quello.
Oramai purtroppo è tardi. Qua hanno fatto, io almeno pensavo di arrivare qui, di trovare una cartolina. La cartolina l'ho trovata via la Iberia.
Ah sì?
Piccola, pulita, c'è proprio un cosino lì, un bonbon messo lì,
sì.
abbandonato, non ci va nessuno. Cioè, è deserta, ma era dicembre che sono dal primo.
Sì.
Mi sono fatto un po' un altro, è la mia meraviglia di tutta sta roba, venire qui, porca puttana, 4, 5, 6 di dicembre, mettermi in mutande a pigliare il sole.
Sì.
Non è possibile, da noi abbiamo un ghiaccio, la neve.
È vero.
Zero, no? Dico, ma tu guarda questi 4 coglioni. I signori li ha baciati, manco per il cazzo, veramente. Poi
sì.
non pensavo che Alassio fosse stata trasformata in tutti questi palazzi indecenti che hanno costruito negli anni,
sì.
perché ci sono ancora molte ville storiche, no? Quindi avessero almeno mantenuto l'architettura un po', quindi che è quella più bella, è quella più non c'è da fare, tutta questa roba lì di ricca messa in piedi. Se potevano arrivare alla fine del cielo.
Sì.
Quindi. Ma vabbè, è la natura dell'uomo, per cui.
Chiaro.
E tanto il declino c'è, è cominciato già da noi negli anni 70, quindi.
Sì.
E il petrolio 200 anni, che qua continuano a far macchine come se avessero scoperto il gas e il petrolio.
Sì.
Sì, esatto, ma 200 anni guarda che non sono pochi.
No. No, per il periodo di tempo che noi siamo qui.
Noi possiamo dire, almeno io a volte penso e dico, noi abbiamo visto tutto.
Sì.
Tutto quello che c'era da vedere l'abbiamo visto, no?
Sì.
Quindi,
e adesso?
Dalla 500 o roba del genere, poi
sì.
parliamo della 500, oppure poi nel filmato a vedere quello che costruiva già l'America, la televisione, la caffettiera, la radice. Comunque
sì.
abbiamo visto tutto.
Sì.
Qua adesso ti dicono che andremo ad abitare su Marte, che io sono fuori di testa.
Vero.
Proprio pensano proprio. E la gente cogliona che gli va dietro, il fatto che saranno. E la nostra cultura, che era una delle culture più, io credo.
Sì.
Era una cultura proprio di quelle, lasciamo stare, dall'era dei Romani, anche prima, la Grecia. Siamo diventati un popolo di ignoranti, da cowboy a piedi.
È vero. Proprio. Strano, adesso che abbiamo la libreria più grande del mondo in ogni casa, dobbiamo essere i più furbi del tutto periodo, però no, al contrario, stiamo diventando più ignoranti.
No, più, siamo proprio...
Siamo andati a essere ignoranti, specialmente con tutto quello che possiamo avere, possiamo sapere tutto. È incredibile,
Ed è questo quello che mi dà fastidio. Cioè, mi dà fastidio perché tanto come dicevamo prima, tanto. E allora goditi
sì.
la vita in un modo che ti piace.
Ecco, bravo, così è.
E poi tanto alla fine dice vabbè, ho fatto quello che ho voluto, quello che mi è piaciuto.
Sì.
Non ho né tanto né poco, sono tranquillo. e buonanotte.
Ha ragione.
Altro non si può fare.
No.
Potessi ritornare indietro e fare solo una cosa, chiederei al padre eterno di mettermi su un'isola di dove ci sono proprio quattro gatti, la televisione,
sì,
il telefono,
sì,
no?
Sì.
Niente, e godermi praticamente la vita in questo modo.
Sì, bravo.
Intanto non costruire neanche i palazzi di quei rettili. Nemmeno lì non ti girano i coglioni. Sei tranquillo, fai quello che vuoi.
Sì.
Vuoi da solo, se vuoi fare un po' tranquillo tutto l'anno. Che
voglio
essere la vita così, secondo me,
ora mi. Sì. Buon auguri, speriamo che.
Guardi,
sì.
È da dicembre.
Perfetto, perfetto.
Me lo porto a casa tutto.
Bravo.
Devo pagare.
Goditelo.
Ora ti ho detto l'altra volta passare con la borsa.
Sì, sì, vi vengo qua spesso.
Bene.
Ciao, buona giornata.
Buona giornata a lei.
Grazie. Okay, we have come to the end of the first part with the sky, and because I have to do it in two parts, because the battery of this camera doesn't last as long, I leave you here, hope you enjoyed it, and that you're going to join me on the second part, where we do just the water and we finish it off, yeah, it's just the sand and whatever we have left to do. Okay, hope to see you soon. See ya, bye bye. Thank you.